tear in your eye, and I'm wondering why, for it never should be there at all. With such power in your smile, sure a stone you'd beguile, so there's never a teardrop should fall.
Overhauls and Mrs. Murphy's chowder. Nobody spoke, so he shouted all the louder. It's an Irish trick, that's true. I can lick the mick that threw the overhauls and Mrs. Murphy's chowder.
Mrs. Murphy gave a party about a week ago. Everything was plentiful. Well, the Murphys, they're not slow. They treated us like gentlemen. We tried to act the same. Only for what happened, it was an awful shame. Mrs. Murphy dished the chowder out and fainted on the spot. She found a pair of overalls at the bottom of the pot. Tim Nolan, he got ripping mad. His eyes were bulging out. He jumped upon the piano and loudly he did shout. Who threw the overhauls in Mrs. Murphy's chowder?
Nobody spoke, so he shouted all the louder.
It's an Irish trick, that's true. I can lick the mick that threw
the overhauls in Mrs. Murphy's chowder.
They dragged the pants from out the soup and laid them on the floor. Each man swore upon his life he'd not seen them before. They were plastered up with mortar and were worn out at the knee. They had their many ups and downs, as we could plainly see. When Mrs. Murphy, she came to, she starts to cry and pout. She'd had them in the wash that day, forgot to take them out. Tim Nolan, he excused himself for what he'd said that night. So we put music to the words and sung with all our might. Who threw the overhauls in Mrs. Murphy's chowder?
Nobody spoke, so he shouted all the louder.
It's an Irish trick, that's true. I can lick the mick that threw
the overhauls in Mrs. Murphy's chowder.
A tear in your eye, and I'm wondering why, for it never should be there at all. With such power in your smile, sure a stone you'd beguile, so there's never a teardrop should fall. When your sweet lilting laughter like some fairy song, and your eyes twinkle bright as can be, you should laugh all the while, and all other times smile. And now smile, a smile for me. Smiling, sure it's like a morn in spring. In the lilt of Irish laughter, oh, you can hear the angels sing. When Irish hearts are happy, all the world seems bright and gay. And when Irish eyes are smiling, sure they steal your heart away. happy. All the world seems bright and gay. And when I steal your heart away.
Bye. Thank you. I'm not going to swear.
We're witnessing the second annual Walsh Uno tournament.
Not quite as exciting as the first
annual Walsh Uno tournament.
I just have my hairstyle. Don't you want to see it?
Uno. Knock it off, Jeanette Mary.
Uno.
Get her.
Hi, Ed.
How are you doing, Marge?
Got it. Aaron's the matriarch of the family.
Rose Kennedy.
Queen Mother.
Thank
you, guys. Where do we go?
We're here at Christmas time at the Walsh house. We're playing Uno, and I think they passed me up. It's Tracy's turn, and the ball's... I know something we can play. Okay, I have this game. It's called Nothing Shaking But the Leaf on a Tree. Okay, you start out.
I have 60 points.
I've got 22. Okay. Hi, this is Bob Walsh, and we're going to take you through a tour of the Walsh house. This is the family room. This is our TV set. This is our Atari. This is the nativity scene. Anybody think? No, it doesn't have anything to say. This is our pool table. This is Billy Sham's box. Forget about that. Okay, we're going to the dining room. This is the dining room. This is the Walshstein. This is Therese. This is Marin's mom. This is our food collection.
I mean, great.
This is, these are Dad's decorations up here, and that's our. This is the refrigerator. This is Mark. Mark, you say anything?
How are you today?
Okay, how are you?
Just fine.
That's good. Okay, who else? We have Bill here. Here's where it all started. Here's the father of the Walsh family, Mr. Frank J. Walsh. There's our cabinet with all our there's Dad's decorations. There's Mom. There's Black and Mary's head, and there's trees. There's our Christmas tree. Isn't that beautiful? Barb and Billy decorated it. I'm Barb. We decorated it. There's Marge. Marge, Jen, come on. Let's get... There they are. There's Kevin, the star. Kevin, get over here. We got to have a few words here. There's Max, the wonder dog. How you doing there, Max? You don't know what you're say?
Oh,
Kevin?
Kevin
thinks he needs a little practice, yeah. There's Marge smiling, isn't she a cutie? All right.
I am.
Say some words.
He's going to be the Kevin tournament.
I got the
good luck. Did you really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
bombers like the GU-52 Iron Annie that you're seeing lifting off the ground right now. One of World War II's best fighters.
And then let's off here.
The Navy, the RAF, and many other foreign air forces. flying classroom trained pilots from over 14 countries during 1942. T-6 dispatched to Mexico, sank two German submarines off the coast of San Diego, so we did see a little bit of action, too. He's got an aircraft, while they're not actually the specific crews, some of their primary and advanced training in some of these aircraft. The Federal Air Force maintains them in hard flying condition so that you can see that particular part of our air heritage.
Thank you. flight of four P-51s. Looks like they're going to peel off into the... Also, the Attorney General of the state of Indiana.
Waiting round the bend, my heart. Okay, ready?
Just a small one.
All right. Ready?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Eric Grace.
Hi, my name is Jim.
And today we bring you the top...
He did really good. Just go right. That's
a great last night. Right. We're going to practice in a minute. And today we're going to bring you the top 50 things you may have heard Barb and Frank say over the past 50.
She'll be finished in 1 second.
And today we're going to hear the top 10 things you may have heard Barb and Frank say over the past 50 years.
Now from our home office in Greenfield, Indiana, the top 10 thing that you would hear Barb and Frank say over the past 50 years.
Number 10, stop wailing like a banshee.
Number 9, there's going to be blood spilled in this room.
Number 8, don't wake up the baby.
That's prescriptive. No, you just think of your own thing. Something
along with that.
Number 7.
Number 6. No, honey, none of you are adopted. I gave birth to each and every one of you.
Number 5. Close the door.
I heard that.
What am I at number 4?
Four.
I'm looking for my keys, honey.
And then what's Mike saying?
Mike's got his thing, number 3, blah, blah, blah.
Okay, number 2.
Number 2, eat your carrots to make your hair curly.
And then, wait.
I haven't decided.
Wait. And finally.
Oh, we all say hey,
no, just
I'll do it. Just on this.
Okay. You step forward, and then you do yours, and step back in, and then we all go,
yay.
And then we go back to our room. And then Tom stands up, and that's what you say.
All grandkids up here, and I'm going to be
hi, baby.
You deserve every second of this.
That's right.
And I love you.
I love you.
Thank you.
There's Grampy out there.
Sweet sound, right?
Church. Maybe.
Hi, how are you?
You're all right. Gotcha.
Very, I don't know. Grace, so if you would require us to remove these, I'm able to God and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Bless us, O Lord, and these thank yous we are about to receive. We thank God and through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you very much. Enjoy.
Example for your family and friends. It is my pleasure to send both of you a pin of our great city. Stop by and see me anytime that you may be downtown.
My tree is cut down in front of Alice.
again, congratulations and enjoy your special day. Sincerely, Rodney Fleming, Mayor of Greenfield. To Barbara and Frank Walsh, having just undergone the experience of being married for 50 years, I rejoice with you on your 50th wedding anniversary. Signed, Bud.
I thought he was dead.
He's pining. Sincerely, Bud Roberts. Mr. and Mrs. Frank Walsh, dear Frank and Barbara, on the occasion of your 50th wedding anniversary, I send you the best wishes of the Virginia Tech Hokies. What a remarkable achievement. Sincerely, Charles Steger, President of Virginia Polytech Institute. Is happy to join your family and friends in wishing you a very happy 50th wedding anniversary. We congratulate you on 50 wonderful years of marriage and well over 50 years of rooting for the Cubs. Luck for the years ahead. We also look forward to seeing you again soon at Wrigley Field. Go Cubs. Sincerely, Jim Hendry, Vice President, General Manager of the Chicago Cubs. He did not say at the bottom, this is you. You need to give him a spell, Mom. You always say, this is your year to me. So. If my siblings would join me.
Hello.
Get started.
Looks like the firing squad.
There's a poor police line on the
say over the past 50 years.
Number 10, stop wailing like a banshee. Number 9, there's going to be blood spilled in this room. Number 8, don't wake up the baby.
Number 7.
Number 6, trust me, honey, none of you are adopted. I gave birth to each and every one of you.
Number 5. Close the door.
Number 4. Honey, I'm looking for my keys. Number 3. No, Tom, these are not instant.
this out, you guys are going to have it for breakfast. Short. He goes,
I love my wild Irish.
someday to her I'll propose, and if she will agree, that's heaven for me. When Frank married his wild Irish rose.
I'd like to propose a toast to Frank and Barbara. Congratulations on 50 years. Thank you for being such a large part of my family and the lives of my dear here. And what else can I say?
It's been a great thing. I want to thank the Walshes of having been with the Murphys for so long and having so much fun in our neighborhood, being together for so long, and such a loving couple who really experienced and given us. My wife and I both have 6 children, and we are looking very much forward to our 50th anniversary this year. Congratulations.
Table is now open to roasting.
Now I will say those nice quiet things to say.
You may now respond to the toast. There you go. Now you can respond.
I am grateful to all of you. Me, your Frank, and I are grateful to have my brother and sister. Grateful for the years that we have been together and put up with each other. And all their lovely children and their grandchildren and everything. Family is such an important thing. I love y'all.
Thank you.
This is the time for the last. Thank you. Kathleen, stand up. I am standing. As the shortest member of the family, I have been asked to do a little remembrance of things past. We're here to celebrate a marriage that spanned 5 decades and has seen the world go from dialed telephones to instant messaging. The world has changed a great deal since August 23rd, 1952, but one thing remains the same, the love, commitment, and sacrifice that it takes to stay married for 50 years, and that's 18,250 days, or 438,000 hours for this beautiful
friend. Must be hoping for parole.
Is enormous. Sends an example to all of us. A good marriage is difficult enough without the support of good friends and loving family. These helping hands have guided Frank and Barbara when they were young, applauded them when they succeeded, and helped them through adversity. We celebrate those hands and those lives today. I have a little celebration film for you that celebrates not just the past, but the future. It's the celebration of the lives of my 2 wonderful parents. I hope you enjoy it.
Jenny. Keep going, Jenny.
I got these two right here.
There you go.
Right here.
It's just for the group.
She's the first one.
Why, I do.
Let's go.
It's a reenactment.
No smushing. No smushing. I don't
remember feeding you.
I do?
No.
Excited to have a tenth child. And I'd like to thank my mom's side for the nose and my dad's side for the ears. Backstroke in the ocean, I think there's a shark. It looks like a taxi cab going down the street with the doors. Heard them all. But it's against my nature to be brief, but I will. First of all, I'd like to thank all of you for coming. It means a lot to my family and means a lot to my parents. Wish we could get up to Chicago and to the other parts more, but as we kind of have not got to see each other, it doesn't break the bond that we all have growing up together. And I miss the Thorntons, I miss the Sanfords, I miss everybody. So hopefully get to celebrate this again in 50 years.
Okay.
So, what's the announcements? My sister Cecil B. Dementini will recognize it. Just joking. I'm ready for my close-up. There is going to be a mass at 6 p.m. It's not, obviously, it's not mandatory. If I walk through there, lightning bolts will be coming down. So it's anybody wants to go there, and then tonight, please, we'll be around the hotel and celebrating and all that. The only things I'd like to say is I've seen a lot of amazing things being at the tail end of a family of 12. I just don't know how, I'm just having trouble with one. I don't know how that ended up happening. But I've seen a lot of amazing things. Like I said, one of the most amazing things I ever saw is when Mom and Dad kissed each other goodbye every day when they left. Which, after 50 years, I hope my wife and I are still in love like that. And I'd also like to say I hope I'm half the parents to my son as you were to all of us. So I said, what are you crying about? I'm kind of crying. Being the biggest Walsh in school. But like, once again, I'd like to thank all of you for being here, and I hope you enjoyed the day. Thanks a lot for coming.
Kind of a tradition.
Yeah, this one's in there too.
Thanks.
Hi. How you doing?
I want this work as much as Tom does.
Really?
I need
Hey, Liam. Hey, Lee, man.
Look in here.
Hey, bud.
See that
Hi.
How are you?
Looks good. I like the
way he acts. Beep, beep.
Look, knuckle one and knuckle two.
Oh, yes. Okay. Move out of the way.
Hooyah.